starting a while ago, we tackled this question of how will climate change affect malaria, because that's, of course, one of the biggest, most important vector-borne diseases. We first studied the effects of climate change on malaria by asking how does temperature in particular affect the mosquito that transmits malaria? And you can measure that in a lab. You can put mosquitoes at different temperatures and you can make a prediction for how temperature affects transmission.
Mosquitoes, all their biologic processes are very dependent on the temperature, right? And it turns out that every single species of mosquito probably has a temperature optimum by which all of its biological processes are actually optimized, right? And so for the malaria vector, Anopheles gambi, that's 25 degrees. But for the dengue or chikungunya vector, Aedes aegypti, that peak is actually 4 degrees hotter. The point is that as the climate changes, these arboviruses, which are currently an underrecognized problem, may become more and more of a problem.
You might think because they're both mosquito-borne diseases that the public health strategies would be similar, but in fact, the public health strategies to control malaria versus dengue are almost completely different. And of course, the drugs that we have for malaria don't work against viruses, so they won't work on dengue. And the diagnostic tests that we have for malaria don't work on dengue. So we need a whole different set of tools in order to control dengue compared to controlling malaria. And then the other side of the control picture is the idea of making sure that communities and community leaders and clinicians understand the risk of arboviruses and understand the difference in ecology between the mosquitoes that transmit dengue and the mosquitoes that transmit malaria, so that when these arbovirus outbreaks do happen, people are ready to act and they're ready to employ new public health control tools.
I think one of the things that's really powerful here is that we're attempting to predict something that may have an impact on millions of people's lives. And hopefully it will get into the right hands of people with power to actually use this information, really think about it critically, and then be very proactive and plotted in the ways that they use their very limited resources to target the highest benefits for human health.